Hello students, welcome to the session. Today I am going to discuss regarding the importance of tongue diagnosis in TCM. When we are dealing with the acupuncture, compared to the diagnostic procedures of conventional medicine, here we follow a different diagnostic methods. Actually, this was evolved, or the diagnostic procedures were used by traditional Chinese medicine practitioners when there was no advanced techniques, diagnostic procedures were available. So, tongue diagnosis is part of the traditional diagnostic procedure. Actually, there are four important aspects in TCM. One is just inspection, second one is palpation, third one is auscultation, and the fourth procedure is history taking. So unlike the conventional medicine practice, first they do the investigations and then history, and then investigations, and then correlate the history with the investigations. But here, first they do the inspection and then they try to correlate with the history and the symptoms. So why tongue diagnosis? Here, tongue represents the parts of the body or the important internal organs, like the heart and small intestine, lung, kidney, liver, gallbladder, and stomach and spleen are represented in different areas of the tongue. So it was one of the major diagnostic methods in Chinese medicine since the Yellow Emperor's time. In Huangdi Nijing, the details of tongue diagnosis is mentioned clearly. The tongue has many relationships in connections to the body, both the meridians and the internal organs. So it can present strong visual indicators of the person's overall health as well as the imbalance. So it can present strong visual indicators of the person's overall balance or imbalance. The internal organ related to the tongue is mainly heart, which is called the important representation of the functions of the spleen too. So channels and meridians are also related either by Leo connecting, that is mainly the heart channel, and by divergent to the branch of the meridians like liver, kidney, urinary bladder, and triple warmer meridian. They connect to the tongue by connecting through the collateral branches, and also by external and internal connections, mainly lung, large intestine, and small intestine, and the gallbladder. So we can see the reflection of these organs in the different parts of the tongue, and the color changes or the texture of the tongue indicates the diseases or the conditions of the internal organ. Here mainly we consider the representation of qi and blood with the tongue. The tongue depends on the qi and blood. If the qi and blood supplies to the entire body in a uniform pattern and in a regular manner, the tongue shows a healthy picture, and the consistency of tongue and the color of the tongue is representing a very normal conditions. Whereas the moisture and dryness of the tongue, coating, and the body are related to the quantity of distribution of fluid as well as qi. So overall, the tongue can reveal the state of viscera, that is internal organ, qi, blood, yin and yang pathogenic factors, and the healthy qi as well as the progress of disease. So by looking at the tongue, we can identify the state of internal organs, whether they are supplied with the proper amount of qi or the blood or the body fluid. Significance of tongue diagnosis. Here it helps to judge the excess or decline of the vital qi. When we look at the color, the red and the moist tongue means the excess of qi and blood, while the pale tongue is the sign of both deficiency of qi as well as the blood. When we look at the white, thin and moist coating indicates the excess of stomach qi. At the same time, if there is no coating at all, it indicates there is a decline of the stomach yin. The other point is to diagnose or to distinguish the nature of disease. If there is no prickle on the tongue surface and the coating is white and moist, or the tongue is bluish black without prickle, that indicates there is cold excess. If there is a red and dry tongue with yellow coating, or red prickle on the tongue with yellow thick or greasy coating, indicates there is heat excess. So this is how we can identify the deficiency or excess as well as the cold or heat excess or deficiency. So how to inspect the tongue? That is an important part. We have to consider the points while inspecting the tongue, mainly the posture of the patient, light during the inspection, and the diet. So these are the contributing factors. When we look at the posture, we have to always consider the patient is in relaxed posture, and also the muscles at the tongue also relaxed. And we can ask the patient to stretch the tongue completely. So when during the process of stretching, we should consider the intense extension of the tongue should be avoided. So it can cause the change in the blood circulation, which also result in the change in the normal color, because extension lead to vasodilatation, or sometimes it can cause the constriction and the blood flow may alter, and which also may be one of the normal contributing factor for change of the color. The light. So normal light, normal natural daylight is ideal for inspecting the color of the tongue. So when we look with any fluorescent color, it can reflect the fluorescent light. So there may be naturally change in the color. So we have to consider this. Then about the effect of diet. So always the food what they consume, or the colored food what they consume before the tongue diagnosis, can also alter the alter the color presentation of the tongue. So for this, better to ask the individual to avoid food at least 1 hour before the tongue inspection. So these are the factors to be considered while diagnosing the tongue. Then the importance and the significance of different conditions will be continued in the next session. Thank you.